Big fish tank right there. Another fish tank right here. But wait till you see what is inside this basement. Here we go.
All right, so you're ready?
Holy moly. What is going on, Cuffaros? Welcome back to another video here. Today, we are going inside this house behind me here. It is a friend of Greg's, and inside the basement is his fish collection. I'm not sure what I'm gonna see. I honestly have no idea. Greg showed me a slight video this morning, and it looked absolutely wild. So I'm looking forward to it. Hopefully you are too. Stick along, and you won't regret it. Straight up these stairs here, just a, you know, normal front door. Wait till you see the basement. Straight down these steps. Holy moly. It is huge. Get some paku in there.
Yep, feed all my fish every 4 days, and these guys get a variety of bloodworms, krill, and tilapia.
There's all sorts of different fish like hiding up. Oh, there's the eel's face.
Yeah.
Coming out of the rocks.
He might come all the way out or...
He thinks you have food.
Yeah.
This is it though, massive, massive tank. Nice rock work in the background too, by the way.
That's a 125 gallon filtration system that I have. So on both corners we have microfilter bags, and then everything goes to the center. I have a 4200 gallon pond pump
that
goes on both sides and then gets filtered through as fast as possible. Also I have a UV light, and also I have a big tube, plastic tube, that has bio balls inside there.
And you got these pakus in here.
Yeah. So I had them when they were probably like maybe only 3 inches long.
Yep.
And
they grow so fast.
Yeah. Well, the more you feed them, the faster that they get bigger. So
yep.
I don't feed them as often, as fast. So right now they're a pretty decent size, but I think about next year they'll be, you know, big enough where I can go ahead and do the Ohio Fish Rescue. Yeah, Ohio Rescue.
Give them over to there, for sure. Yeah. They've got plenty of room for those guys. All right, now you're probably saying to yourself, wow, this is, you just got that dope 200 gallon right there, and this little tank, oh no. Tim has got this door right here, and this door right here is where we were about to enter the basement.
Besides me showing fish and fish tanks, also I do show fish too, so, for the past those 2 years, these are all the awards that I've won so far.
There you go. You know,
from the aquatic experience, from the two clubs. I belong to the Green Water Society Club, and also GCCA, Chicago Cichlid Association. So I have won awards there. So I'm going to go back again this year.
And hopefully get another one for right here.
All this thing will probably be covered this year.
I like that attitude.
Hopefully.
There you go.
Definitely.
What is going on?
All right, so we have right in front a 125 gallon fish tank. That's kind of like a holding for some fish that I have until I put them in there for the rest of their lives.
Yep, you know what the crazy part is? From the outside of this house, you would never expect, I'm sorry for the dark lighting, but you would never expect something like this to be in it.
I know.
You're just like, there's a basement down here and look what it is. It's like full of fish tanks.
Yeah, this is half a basement. If there's a full basement, it'd be a lot more. On each level, we have 5 29 gallon fish tanks.
Yep.
And we have a couple 55s.
Jules, these are, we actually catch these in Miami.
Oh, yeah.
So in Miami, those are in the wild. I actually use them as bait too, because they're pretty much a nuisance invasive species. And catch them, use them as bait for peacock bass.
Oh yeah. And we have a chocolate cichlid. He is in a stage where he has a bloat issue,
yep,
which is being corrected, and it's almost gone, but he still has it a little bit.
See, it kind of floats a little bit.
Yes.
Yeah. Best of luck, buddy. You know what's cool about down here is a lot of fish places, especially this many tanks, is it's not humid.
Yeah.
It's not humid at all.
Yeah, I have a couple of fans going, and I have my humidity, so it tells me exactly, you know, it is 80 degrees in here, but it's still at 47 degrees,
so the humidity. Yeah. So he's got a little dial right here. Awesome. All right, well, there's the name. It's way too confusing of a name. I've never seen that fish in my life. Looks pretty cool.
There's a male and a female in there.
And you're waiting for him to have some babies?
Trying to.
Look at that. So dope.
And then also I have the Cuban cichlid, male and female.
Oh my gosh.
Yep.
I've never seen that fish in my life. Oh wow, you're aggressive.
Yeah.
So
he's a Cuban cichlid.
Oh my goodness.
And there's the female right there. So I have him separated because he did attack the female on the back right there. So I want her to heal until it goes. But they have had the babies before. There's a few of them in there somewhere.
Oh, yeah. That thing is mean. Look at it. He just wants to bite the camera. And then up here, what do we got going on? Just a little sort of cichlids.
Yeah, a couple of red devils. There is a Madagascar, a Polinati. He's probably in that tube up there.
Yeah.
Yeah. He's just hiding. You know.
Little camera shy.
I also have a flower horn.
Yes. Where's that thing at? It's inside there. You can kind of see it. Let me get a flashlight on it real quick. Little better of a view on that fish.
Another polonati from Madagascar. There's a male and two females in there. When you see it on the wall right there from Aquatic Experience 2017, this is my female that I have that won.
So cool. That's a big one.
Yeah.
Real big one.
And then these two here, on the bottom here, I have the Texas cichlids.
Yeah.
Male and female.
They look like they're doing pretty good.
Yeah. I thought that they were going to make some babies pretty soon because they moved all the gravel.
They're moving all the gravel up.
Exactly.
Yeah. Looks like it.
And then right next to it is the Jack Dempsey's.
When they get big and their colors really like pop, they are such good looking fish.
I mean, these are the electric blue jeans.
That's the one, the electric blue.
The electric blues, they have the real nice blue to them.
It is just glowing blue in there. So it's just straight glass and you got these little suction cups.
So on every single tank that's down here, all the glass tops I cut, all the backs of them have water coming in, water coming out, and also oxygen.
Yep.
Every single one I drilled by hand, by myself, because I have the hole saws, diamond bit hole saws, so I cut everything. I wanted to make it look as nice as possible.
It does look very nice, by the way.
I don't want nothing to come up and over the tank, so everything is all drilled.
Coming in here, it looks absolutely amazing. And we'll get a fire thumbnail in just a second.
Everything on this wall, you know, all the medication that I need, any foods that I need, everything that has to do with fish is in here.
Right on this wall, even minions.
Yep.
Two minions.
What? He's a Costa Rica blue dobai.
That thing is. I don't think the camera doesn't really show it. There he comes. Look at the face. That is a mean looking face.
So the dobai has a couple different names.
Ooh.
One of them a lot of people know of his name is that the wolf cichlid, because he has those two big canine teeth right in front.
Yep. You see him.
And you can catch him in Florida.
You can catch pretty much anything where I live.
Yeah.
There is all sorts of every cichlid species you could think of.
I believe you can catch these guys in Florida.
Yes,
and
you can.
They are called chickens.
Yep.
But
everyone calls them chickens.
I don't know why.
Or Midas cichlids.
That's
another word.
Yeah.
I have five of them. Come here, buddy.
This is something that is really, it is rare.
That really shows it. Once you get a flashlight on that fish, you said these are kind of rare?
Because of the size.
Yeah.
Because they're very, very slow growing fish.
Yep. Okay, we'll leave him alone.
It takes years and years and years for him to get big.
Yeah.
Because we have ones in the other tank.
Yep.
What you've seen, there's only like my three
over
or four
there.
Inches.
Yep.
This one is 7 inches. These are babies. There's like three babies that I have in there.
Hey, little guys. They're chilling. Little tiny ones.
About it. This one is healing his tail.
Yep.
I got him free. I rescued him. So I do rescue some fish.
Show your side, not your face. You're beautiful. There we go.
Yeah, he's got real nice color tone. It's just that his tail's kind of a little beat up, but he's gonna recover soon.
Just a few more fish up here.
Male bit the female, she's recovering.
Hey, little Texas cichlid.
And sometimes you hear like pounding on the glass.
Yeah.
He plays with the air stone.
Oh.
But take it and lift it up and drop it back down again.
Oh, now he sees me. What's up, buddy? There we go. So for anyone that's not familiar with this kind of filtration, is on one side it's going in, it goes through everything, and then on the other side it's coming out. But in this case, it's going this way.
Yeah.
But that's how it goes. It's going in, it's filtering through every different little stage, and then it's coming out and then back into the tank. And that's pretty much what it does.
Correct. Yes. So the other tank is doing these three over here.
Yep. If you actually look closely, you can see all the little PVC work back there. It's a lot of work. So that is pretty much a wrap on this basement aquarium. Look at this. Is that absolutely insane? Shout out to Tim here. Tim, thank you.
All right,
thank you so much. Do you want to shout out anyone? Anything of?
Well, I like to say that, you know, if anybody want to get in touch with me, the Greater Chicago Cichlid Association.
Yep.
Because I've been doing them for like about 4 years, and also Primetime Aquatics. They also come to my house. They actually have to come back and refilm again.
Yeah.
So everything you see here is going to be filmed with them again.
This is true.
With you.
Hey. Awesome. Right. That is the basement aquarium. That is a homeowner's basement aquarium collection. This is insane, and mostly cichlids. That's really,
yes.
You're a cichlid guy. You see all the rewards that he's earned, so clearly yes. You're doing something right.
A little bit, yeah.
There you go. Thank you, Tim. Look at this view to wake up to. Is that insane? Look how big that catfish is. This is insane. This is Greg's backyard. There's frickin' Frack, his two ducks, and there's a big old house right there with a lot of water in the backyard. Perfect place to end the video. If you have not done so already, join the family. Hit the subscribe button down below. It's completely free. And then after you do that, you click the bell and you'll be notified every time I upload. If you want to see more stuff like this, be sure to do those two things. Today's positive comment shout out goes out to Trout Lane. I don't own fish, but I'm getting some of my own fish for my birthday 26.